Hi and welcome to the Chaos Destruction for Absolute Beginners. Let's cover the basics of the Chaos Destruction system so you can have a nice starting point for future projects. I recommend downloading a free PDF guide from the link in the description. This way you will have all the information, values and steps from this video in one place for future reference. The first thing to do is to choose first person template for our project. If you are new to the engine, just hold down the right mouse button and use W, A, S and D keys to move just like in a FPS game, and go up and down with E and Q keys. Let's now make this blue cube destroyable. Click on it, go to the drop down menu, select fracture mode. Make sure that the blue cube is selected, otherwise we won't have this new option. With cube selected, hit new. And just click Create Geometry Collection. You can see our cube changed color. If I press Ctrl Space to open Content Browser and select Content Folder, you can see that Unreal Engine created our destroyable cube over here. Okay, click this dock in the layout icon and select another cube and replicate the process. Click New, but this time name the cube if you want. You can see the Unreal Engine does not destroy the original cube. Instead, it just creates a destructible version of the object. Okay, let's add fracture to the cube. Select our cube and click this Uniform Fracture icon. You can see that our cube is broken into pieces. Since this is a beginner tutorial, I won't go into details about this. You can always play with options how you like. Okay, let's scroll a bit down our menu to see the fracture button. Now click it to add pieces. The more you click, the more pieces it will add. But be aware it will be heavy on your computer performance. You can check how it looks if you scroll up and change this explode amount. The nice thing is that you can select individual fractures and fracture them more. Select one piece and click fracture again to see the result. If you accidentally deselect your cube, you can always select it on the right side. Make sure to select level 0 to select it whole. And you can also select individual pieces here if you want to fracture them individually. Okay, let's use the move tool W to move our cube in the air and see how it falls and breaks. Click play. Cool. If you want the object to preserve its looks, make sure to select your cube and type in the details panel bone and deselect these show bone colors. Now our object will be as it was before. Let's now make our gun able to break our cube parts. To do this, go to the content drawer and type in projectile. Open this BP first person projectile. Don't worry about the options here, we just need to change two things. Go to Viewport tab, on the left side select Sphere, scroll down, and under Collision presses change to Block All Dynamic. And under Scale change all three values to be 0.5. Quick tip, if you click this lock icon you can change all the values at the same time. Click compile and save. Now if we click play, we can break our cube and cause imminent destruction in our level. Nice. Let's now replicate the same process to other objects so we can destroy our whole level. This way you will put what you learn into action. Try yourself or go with me. One tip, you can select multiple objects by holding the Shift key. But it's important to select those very close to each other, otherwise it will make strange fractures that we don't want. This way we save lots of time. And now just go as usual, go fracture, click New, Save, add some fracture to the object, and you can deselect Show Bone Colors if you want. Select the next object or cluster objects and so on. Do this to all objects except walls and floor. And if we click play, we can destroy our level and feel good about it. And that's how you start with Chaos Engine in Unreal Engine 5. I hope you learned something new and useful from this video. If you like this quick tutorial, feel free to check out my other beginner-friendly tutorials about Unreal Engine. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.